Here we're going to solve a system of linear equations using what's called the substitution method. Okay, so let's say that you wanted to solve the following system of linear equations. Okay, let's say the first line was x plus 2y is equal to negative 5, and the second line is given by 2x minus 3y is equal to 11. Okay, so when I put a brace here, that's telling us that these two lines are to be thought of as together. That is, we're looking for an ordered pair that's on the first line, but that's also on the second line. So if we think graphically about what we're asked to do here, we're looking for a point that's on both lines. And so that's going to look something like this. You know, if I go ahead and just generally think of what happens when you have two lines. Well, here's the x-axis and the y-axis. And let's say I graph two lines now. Let's say there's my first line, and let's say here's my second line. So the point of intersection, that is this point right here, that would be the solution to the system. So what we mean when we say, oh, solve a system of equations, that means find the point where the two lines intersect. Okay, so back over here to our system of equations, we have two lines, and I'm wondering where do they intersect. So the way the substitution method works is you look at both lines and you ask yourself, is it easy to get one of the variables in one of the equations by itself? So for example, is it easy to get x or y by itself in this first equation? Well, it's pretty easy to get x by itself, right? All I have to do for this first equation is subtract 2y from both sides. Now, is it easy to get x by itself in the second equation? Well, it's not hard, but at some stage you're going to have to divide by 2. The fact that you're going to have to divide by 2 means that you're going to end up with something that's a little more complicated than what you would have had if you decided to solve the x by itself in the first equation. Okay, so you choose one of the variables to get by itself in one of the equations. So I'm going to decide to get the x by itself in that first equation. Okay, so I take that first equation, x plus 2y equals negative 5, and I write it off to the side right here, and I isolate that x. So I subtract 2y from both sides. And what do I get when I do that? Well, I get x on the left, and on the right-hand side I get negative 2y minus 5. Okay? So the equation x equals negative 2y minus 5, you know, this is the equation of a line, and this is the same line as this line, right? They represent the same line, but in this case I have x isolated. So what I'm going to do now is consider the same system, but with this first equation replaced with that first with this equation. So I'm going to rewrite this. Here we go. Instead of what I have there, I'm going to write x equals negative 2y minus 5, right, which is what I got here. The second equation I'm going to leave alone for the moment. And I have, let's see, 2x minus 3y equals 11. Okay, so once we do that, now what we're going to do is we're going to take advantage of the fact that these two lines, right, this line and this line, those two lines intersect. Now, where they intersect, if you recall our graph over here, what's true? Well, the x-coordinates and the y-coordinates are the same. After all, a point of intersection is a point that lies on both lines. And so they share the same x-coordinate and the same y-coordinate. And so what that means is that looking back here, this x in the first line, or in the first equation, that x is the same as this x. And so I'm going to substitute. That is, I'm going to replace this x with that x. Okay? But that x is equal to negative 2y minus 5. So this x must be equal to negative 2y minus 5 as well. Okay, so what that means is I take that second equation, which is 2x minus 3y equals 11, and I make use of that. That is, if the first x is equal to negative 2y minus 5, the second x, that is this x, must be negative 2y minus 5 as well. So I'm going to replace this x with negative 2y minus 5. And here we go. So the 2 remains the same, it's 2. And we said it becomes negative 2y minus 5, right? And I still have minus 3y, that hasn't changed, equals 11. Okay, so make sure you understand what happened there. I substituted, for this x, I substituted the expression negative 2y minus 5, okay? And that's why this is called the substitution method, because you're replacing, if you will, the variable with an expression you found from the other line. And now at this stage, you should have a line with only one variable. And it's true, I only have y here. And I know how to solve that for y. I simply distribute the 2, so I get, let's see, it's going to be negative 4y, 2 times negative 5 is negative 10, minus 3y equals 11. And then I combine like terms on the left-hand side. So it's negative 7y minus 10 equals 11. And I'm going to add 10 to both sides. And now let's see, I've got, well, it's going to be negative 7y on the left-hand side, and on the right-hand side, I'm going to have positive 21. And now I divide both sides by negative 7. And then negative 7's cancel, and I get y is equal to, well, let's see, a positive divided by a negative is a negative, and 21 divided by 7 is 3. Okay, so y is equal to negative 3. But remember, when you solve a system, you're looking for a point where the lines cross. Now that point has two coordinates. It has an x-coordinate and a y-coordinate. So this isn't the solution. This is only part of the solution, right? You have to specify x and y. So how are you going to find x? We found y already. Well, what we're going to do is we're going to make use of the fact that there are lots of equations here that connect x and y. So looking at all these equations, I say to myself, well, is there one that easily gives me x? And there is. That equation is right up here. Remember how we already isolated the x? We got x is equal to negative 2y minus 5. Well, if that's true, let's go ahead and write that over here. Right? We have x is equal to negative 2y minus 5. If that's always true, well, then if I know y, I can get my x. So I plug this y back in here to get my x. So x is equal to negative 2 times, let's see, y was negative 3. So negative 3 minus 5, and I get x is equal to, well, negative 2 times negative 3 is positive 6, minus 5, so x is equal to positive 1. And that means my x is 1 and my y is negative 3. So my solution is the ordered pair 1, negative 3. And that's where these two lines cross. So this would be the solution to my system of linear equations. Okay, let's try another one like that. Let's say that we wanted to solve, and we had, let's say, x over 2 minus y over 3 is equal to 2. And the second line, let's say I had 2x minus y is equal to, how about 9? Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to try to clear fractions in that top equation. So how are we going to do that? Well, can't I multiply both sides of that top equation by 6? That is, can't I clear fractions by multiplying both sides by the LCD? I can. So let's go ahead and do that. So the left-hand side, multiply that by 6, 6 over 1, and same thing with the right-hand side, 6. Okay, so when I do that, I'm going to get what? Well, let's see. 2 goes into 6 3 times, and 3 times x is 3x. And then minus, 3 goes into 6 2 times, and 2 times y is 2y. And on the right-hand side, I have 12. And the bottom equation remains 2x minus y equals positive 9. Okay, so now remember, to use a substitution method, what you want to do is say, well, is there one variable that's easy to get by itself? Now, this, this, and this are all difficult to get by themselves because they all have a coefficient that's not a 1 or a negative 1. The variable that's easy to get by itself would be this y right here because the coefficient is a negative 1. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's take this equation and get the y by itself. So let's see, I've got 2x minus y equals 9, and I'm going to solve for y. So I'm first going to subtract 2x from both sides. And on the left-hand side, I have negative y. Don't forget the negative. That's still there, right? Equals negative 2x plus 9. And now y is not yet isolated. Now I'm going to divide both sides by negative 1. And let's see, the negative 1's cancel, and I get y is equal to, it's going to be positive 2x, and then minus 9 is what we're going to get. So now what we're going to do, well, I've isolated the y in the second equation, right? So the first equation's going to remain the same. But I'm going to replace this with my simplified form, if you will. So I'm going to keep, let's see, 3x minus 2y equals 12. But I'm going to replace the second equation with y equals 2x minus 9. Okay, so now what do we do? Well, now we're going to take advantage of the fact that, well, these y's are the same. That's the whole idea when you solve a system of linear equations by substitution, that these y's are the same, which means that if this y is equal to 2x minus 9, this y is equal to 2x minus 9 as well. So I'm going to take this y and replace it with 2x minus 9. Okay, here we go. So 3x minus 2y equals 12. And it's going to become, well, 3x minus 2, y is equal to 2x minus 9, equals positive 12. And now I'm going to distribute the negative 2. So I've got 3x, let's see, it's going to be minus 4x. And now negative 2 times negative 9 is positive 18, and that's equal to 12. And so let's see, 3x minus 4x is negative x, plus 18 is equal to 12. And now we're going to subtract 18 from both sides. And we get negative x is equal to negative 6. And now I divide both sides by negative 1. And I get, let's see, x equals positive 6. Now remember, this is only half the solution. You have to go back and figure out what your y is. And you can do that by making use of the fact that y right here is equal to 2x minus 9. So I can take the x here, take the x here, and the x equals 6, and replace the x here with that 6. Okay, so I have y equals 2x minus 9, which means y is equal to, if x is 6, 2 times 6 minus 9. I get 12 minus 9, so y must be equal to 3, which means my solution is the ordered pair 6, 3. And that's where these two lines cross. So in this case, I solved my system of linear equations.